Hi there, my name is Graham McCarty. I'm a local foods and small farms extension educator with University of Illinois Extension, serving Joe Davis, Stephenson, and Winnebago counties. This week on Get Growing, we're talking about the tomato and tobacco hornworm, one of the most destructive insects that we see on tomato plants during the growing season. We'll talk about the difference between the tobacco and the tomato hornworm. We'll also discuss what some of the damage typically looks like when it comes to this insect pest. And of course, we'll talk about where some suggestions when it comes to controlling this insect on your tomato plants. Tomato and tobacco hornworm is one of the most destructive insects that we see on tomato plants. And the reason for it is that they are very big insects and they just consume and consume and consume, compared to, say, whiteflies or aphids, which are much smaller and usually don't have as severe damage like a hornworm will. When I started harvesting my tomatoes in the last week, I started to notice some damage on the actual plant. And this is actually what you see here with the hornworm, is that they have come through and they have actually defoliated parts of my plant where they are eating the leaves and sometimes even eating the fruit, depending on how hungry they are. Depending on how many you have, this could really start to defoliate a lot of your plant, especially as the plant is just starting to produce fruit and starting for that fruit to develop much further. After seeing initial damage from what I suspected was the hornworm, I decided to look and see if I could actually see these insects. And sure enough, I found some. I only found about 5 from a single plant, which is what you see here. Although other co-workers in our extension office shared that they got close to 20 that they were removing by hand from a single plant. So I'm about on the lower end. And if you've never seen a hornworm before, they're a very significant size insect. And so I'm going to try to grab one here so you can kind of see what they look like. So, I mean, this is one of the bigger ones, so it's pretty big compared to some of the other ones you might encounter. Some of the ones that I have are pretty small as of right now, and are kind of a smaller size, which is what I have on this one. But it certainly depends. You may find that you go out and you have a lot of very big hornworms, or you may find you have some very smaller ones. If you want to know whether or not you have a tobacco or a tomato hornworm, there's a couple of things you want to look for. You will find that the tail will be a different color. So this red tail or red horn, which you actually see here, distinguishes that this is a tobacco hornworm. A tomato hornworm will have a black tail. It will also have a different pattern on the side of it as well, which would distinguish between a tobacco or a tomato hornworm. So it doesn't really matter that this is a hornworm on a tomato plant. It still is a tobacco hornworm that's causing the damage. So when it comes to managing the hornworms, the main recommendation we have at the University of Illinois Extension Office is to remove the hornworms by hand. So I would come through and I would remove them by hand. But as I'm doing this, I might encounter a hornworm that has very small white capsules up against it. And so those are actually parasitoid wasp eggs. If I encounter a hornworm that has these wasp eggs, I want to keep it alive and I want to keep them into the garden because those eggs will hatch and potentially that can be a predator that controls some of this other vegetable insect pests that I'm dealing with in my summer garden this season. So that's this week on Get Growing. When it comes to managing hornworms, the best suggestion that we have is to remove them by hand. And this may mean that you're removing a lot of them, or you may find that you're removing just a little bit. As you start to remove them by hand and destroy them, be on the lookout every couple of days for additional hornworms that may have hatched and may be going after your tomato plants. When it comes to insecticides, you may also find that some are available to you, and yet the easiest solution right now is to actually pick and remove the hornworms by hand. For more information on resources and upcoming events, please visit extension.illinois.edu/JSW or follow us on Facebook at Northwest Illinois Local Foods.